Okay, let's say black plays e6, it stops knight h4. White can play c4 immediately. Sometimes white prepares this move playing a3 first, but I think white does not need to do this preparatory move right now. In the case of black's knight b4, a3 will be played, and knight c2 is not dangerous because of rook a2. The c2 knight is not stable. White has good chances to trap it. If knight goes to b6, white can first develop the queenside minor pieces, knight c3, bishop e7, his dark squared bishop can go to f4, and after black castles, I would think about queen b3. White can target the b7 pawn, c5 is coming, a4, a5 alternatively, white can centralize the rooks to plan the pawn breakthrough in the middle, I mean the d5 move. White again seems to be better, he has either play, and black is kind of passive. If knight goes to f6, knight h4 becomes possible again. If black brings the bishop to g6, white can take it. Maybe not immediately, but later on, white can first develop the knight. Knight c3, let's say bishop d6, g3, to be sure that the h2 pawn is safe. And after black castles, I think it's time to take the light squared bishop. After h takes on g6, black cannot target the white's king on the h-file, so white can continue with bishop g5 to pin the f6 knight. Again, white has the center, he has a bishop pair, and can further improve his position on the king side, potentially h4, h5, to open up the h-file and activate his light squared bishop. White seems to be good. If black exchanges the bishop for the knight instead of bishop g6, bishop takes on b1. The position is very similar to what we just discussed. Rook takes on b1. Bishop d6, queen c2. The e2 square is occupied, so the queen can go to c2, and white clears the d1 square for the rook. After black castles, white plays g3, followed by rook d1. Again, the g3 move is kind of prophylactic move. White wants to be sure that his h2 point is safe, and he also guards the h4 knight just in case if black wants to play against it. Again, the same reason, white has a bishop pair, white has better situation in the middle of the board, so white should be better. Okay, the key point to emphasize about d takes on e5, white takes back with the knight, and at some point, if black plays knight d7 and white has no tactical tricks, it's probably better to avoid simplifications. White can move the knight back, but in doing so, he can keep more pieces on the board, and it makes it harder for black to develop. Okay, the most principal continuation for black is bishop g4 to pin the f3 knight and then to attack the e5 pawn. White plays bishop e2. If d takes on e5, again, white uses the knight to take back. And after bishop takes on e2, queen takes on e2, white can play queen b5 later on. White can push the c pawn to attack the d5 knight. White can castle and make a rook lift, rook d1, rook d3 to put more pressure on the black's king side. White seems to have pretty simple, straightforward play, either in the middle or on the king side. If black plays c6, white castles. If at some point black decides to exchange the bishop for the knight, it should be a good trade for white. White plans to play c4. In the case of d takes e6, queen goes to e2. C4 is coming. to develop the dark squared bishop, white can consider b3 followed by bishop b2, knight d2, knight e4, knight can aim at the d6 square, or after white puts the knight to e4, bishop g5 or knight g5 can be considered. Again, white seems to have a pretty simple play and bishop pair. Okay, let's say black plays e6 instead. White castles, black develops the bishop, bishop e7, and c4. It's time to play active moves. Knight usually goes to b6, h3. When white plays this move, he should expect not only retakings, but also bishop takes on f3. However, if black plays it immediately, white can take back with the bishop, and black has no time to take the c4 pawn. First of all, bishop takes on b7, another reason queen a4 check. So black is not ready to give up the bishop. He usually plays bishop h5. White plays bishop e3 to support the d4 pawn, just to move the bishop out, and after short castle, knight c3. These moves are very natural for white. It's time for black to develop the queenside knight. It can go either to c6 or d7 squares. In the case of knight c6, d5 can be played with a tempo. First, white takes on d6, e takes on d6, c takes on d6, and then d5. When white plays this move, he weakens the e5 square, so he should predict what happens after bishop takes on f3, bishop takes back, and then knight e5. But in this situation, after d takes on e6, f takes on e6, white can target the e6 pawn immediately, bishop g4. And after knight takes, white can activate the queen. Queen takes back, the e6 and the d6 pawn are pretty weak. White can also target the black's king side, playing bishop d4, bishop h6. White brings the rooks to the middle to increase the pressure in the middle. So white again seems to have simple play and should be better. Another typical move for black that white should expect is d5. White can try to activate the b6 knight or just take the center. Sometimes white takes on d5 and plays queen b3 to target the queen side. However, in this position, I would recommend to play c5. Knight c4, I think it's not good for black. White can exchange the bishop for the knight and then quickly target the c4 pawn, queen e2, for instance. If black takes the f3 knight, use the pawn to take, g takes on f3. It does not weaken the position of the white king, and instead white just gets the g-file at the disposal that he can use to target the black king. Knight c4 still can be not good, because after bishop takes, d takes, and queen a4, white can take this pawn. Next move already. Otherwise, if knight goes down, let's say knight c8, white can start pushing the kingside pawns, f4, king h2, rook g1, white can also advance the queenside pawns to expand on both sides of the board. Black is very passive. Black has no counterplay, and I think it's very unpleasant for him to defend the position like this. And the last move that we will consider today is knight bd7. So in this case, white's d5 is not so efficient. Instead, white can take on d6. Otherwise, black could exchange light squared bishop for the knight and take the e5 pawn, so e takes on d6. C takes on d6 and b3. It's a good way to limit the b6 knight to guard the c4 pawn. Again, white should expect that black can play bishop takes on f3 because of the c4 pawn. White can be not able to take back with the bishop, so b3 is a good prophylactic move. And let's say after knight f6, rook c1, rook c8, one idea that white can try in this position is g4. bishop g6, knight h4. White wants to get a bishop pair. The bishop cannot escape. In the case of bishop e4, white just uses the g5 move to target the f6 knight and then to win this bishop. Otherwise, at some point, white will take on g6. White can consider h4, h5 plan or d5 or maybe f4, f5. Again, what is good about the position of white? He has pretty clear play. He has the center. He has a bishop pair. And for black, it's much harder to find a counterplay. His pieces are limited and white should be better. Okay, that's it for today. When you play against the Alekhine system, remember you usually get more room due to your pawns in the middle of the board. So avoid simplifications, try to be energetic, try to push more pawns forward, and you should be better. It was Nadezhda Kosintseva for chesslectures.com. Thank you for watching.